morning, students. Children, today we are going to start a new chapter, lesson number 13, Our Earth's Natural Satellite. We live on Earth. And what is an Earth? It is a planet. Like the other planets, Mercury, Venus, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. Pluto was once considered as a planet, but the scientists, they have now named it as a dwarf planet, means it doesn't fulfill all the categories which a planet should have. Children, constantly the scientists are researching. They are finding new things in the space. So it is constantly changing. New asteroids, meteoroids and other comets, even the moons are also constantly being discovered time and again. Space is something which is a mystery. People are always attracted towards it. We have studied in social science that how Humayun was also interested in space and used to go to the terrace and look at the sky and observe many things. And so we can understand that space is a center of attraction from olden times. Galileo, he discovered telescope. Copernicus, they were ancient scientists who had discovered that Earth moves like other planet around the sun. Now what is sun? Sun is a star. All the planets, till date, 8 planets in our solar system, the galaxy with sun at the center, that is the star. There are innumerable stars in the planet, like the star which we are moving around. Similarly, the planets, these 8 planets also have moons. And what are moons? The natural satellite which are revolving not around the star or the sun, it is revolving around the planet. So, the moon which you always gaze at in the sky, it is something very interesting, something very lovable to all people from a baby till the when we grow old. Even babies, there are many poems, rhymes, lories, which you can say lullaby, related to moon. Moon is our nearest neighbor in the space. Okay, in the space, it is our nearest neighbor. Children, moon is a natural satellite. What are artificial satellites? They are the spacecraft which are sent in the space to do all the research work to find out different things. As you know that Mission Mangal and all these things we are sending to the space. So they are artificial satellites. Children, till day, the scientists, they say that there are about 171 moons, total moons, natural satellites of different planets. But children, there are more in waiting. Scientists have discovered more and more, and they are taking many things into consideration, and then they will declare that that is the moon of the so and so planet. Mercury and Venus do not have any moons. Only these two planets, which are the nearest to the sun, they don't have the planet, means the moon, okay, the natural satellite. As you know, our Earth has one natural satellite, Mars, that is also our nearest planet, okay, is having 2 moons. Jupiter is having 66, but more are, means the scientists have found more, but they have not yet, put it in the tally. Saturn 62, Uranus 27. Neptune 18. Okay, till date 171, but there are about 205 moons till they found, but not, different categories they have to consider, different features they have to consider. So whatever it is, our Earth is having only one natural satellite, which is the moon, which is formed from the earth. Okay, and till date all the means you cannot say that scientists have been sure that how it has been formed, but it is said that it has been formed when maybe the other some other planet may have banged to the earth and you know some portion has flung away and formed the moon. So the moon is our natural satellite. It is the closest neighbor in the space. A satellite is an object which revolves around the planet. So in this chapter we are going to talk about the moon. Thank you.